The left side is a Lora client with a solder near the sensor. And right side is a Lora server with an OLED display displayed the temperature and humidity data. We can see at the OLED display that temperature is increasing slowly. So, our experiment is done. The data transmission is successfully transmitted from Lora client and displayed at server. In this video, we will learn how to send sensor data from Lora to Lora using Lora Shield and Arduino. So it will be two Arduinos with Lora Shield. One Lora is a client, it has a sensor that will send the data to another Lora that is server. The data will shown on second Lora that has an LCD display. So the idea is I will send the data from first Arduino with the sensor, and I will display the data at second Arduino with an LCD but without sensor. So, the setup will prove that the communication between two Arduinos is working. If you are looking for basic Lora tutorial, you can watch my another video, link at top right corner, or you can find at the description below. For this example, I will use a DHT11 sensor. It's actually an easy to use and cheap sensor. Has two output that is temperature and humidity. Make it easy for an example. This is the first Arduino and Lora Shield that we will use as client or data sender. And this is the second Arduino that we will use as a server. So this is the wiring diagram. After attach the Lora Shield to Arduino, then simply add the DHT sensor to Arduino client. You can use breadboard like this. Make sure that you connect the sensor data to pin 5 of Arduino. Now that sensor has connected, let's test the sensor first. Open the Arduino IDE and upload this sketch. This is sketch to read the DHT11 sensor at pin 5. You can copy the entire code from my website milliohm.com, link in the description. After upload is complete, open the serial monitor. The data is shown on serial monitor. This means that the sensor is working. Now, time to send the sensor data to Lora server using Lora. I will add the program to send sensor data using Lora in this sketch. And I will explain the sketch too. So, at first, I add the library of Lora and make an object for Lora. Then I init the Lora and set the frequency. Because my Lora using 433 MHz of frequency, it's written 433. And then I send the data to server. Before send the data, I will mix the data to one variable so that it will easier to send. I use the dash or hyphen symbol as data separator between humidity and temperature. So the data become humidity dash temperature. I use data.length to get the data length and make variable called total that will store the data that will be sent. To send the data, I need to convert the variable to char array, so it will fit the library. After the data is ready to send, I call the function rf95.send and give that function data and data length as parameter. And then wait until the data is sent by call rf95.writePacketSend. And it's done. upload the sketch and then open the serial monitor. If your serial monitor displays like this, then everything should be good. Now, time to code the Lora server. Open another instance of Arduino. Don't just open new file from this window that already opened, because it can run different COM port at same time. This is the server sketch. You can copy and paste this sketch from milliohm.com. Link in the description below. Upload the code and open the serial monitor. The server Arduino is on COM12 and the client is on COM11. Before we continue the video, please consider subscribe and turn on the notification so it will encourage us to make more videos and happy. Open all serial monitor so that we can watch the data being sent by client and received by server. Left is the client and on right is the server. Now we know that the data are successfully sent by client and received on a LoRa server by looking at the server serial monitor. It displays the same data as the client. It's not satisfying if data only shown at serial monitor. I want the data shown on LCD at server, so it will look nice. I attach an OLED LCD to Arduino server. This is the wiring diagram. After the wiring is completed, then copy the server sketch with LCD. These are the libraries we use. We make LoRa object. This is size of OLED display LCD we use. If you want detailed tutorial on how to use this OLED display, you can watch my another video. Link on the right corner and at the description below. So in this video, I will focus on LoRa code. In setup, we will init the LoRa and then set the frequency of the LoRa. Then in loop, we receive the data from another LoRa by call the function named RF95 with available timeout. I give the function with parameter 500. This means that if it waits more than 500 milliseconds, it will time out. But if there is incoming data, then I will print the data at the serial monitor, convert the data to string, and then we spirit the data by using function called explode. This function will spirit the data by using dash or hyphen symbol as spirator. After the data is received, then we will print the data at OLED display by called function named printtag. And this is the explode function. It will convert the data to char array and then spirit the data using the dash or hyphen symbol. then it will store the first data in its variable. And then the function will store the second data to t variable. And this is the separation symbol. You can use whatever separation symbol you like. And this is the function printtext to print the data to the LCD or to the OLED display. Upload this sketch and test. We should see the temperature and humidity displayed at the OLED display. This means that the data are received successfully at LoRa server. Now, I will try to hit the sensor by placed a solder near the sensor and see what happened. The left side is LoRa client with a solder near the sensor. And right side is LoRa server with an OLED display displayed the temperature and humidity data. We can see at the OLED display that temperature is increasing slowly. So, our experiment is done. The data transmission is successfully transmitted from LoRa client and displayed at server. Thank you for watching, and if you think this video is useful, consider to subscribe, turn on the notification, and share to your friends. See you on another video. Bye.